Ellis in the group says it's one thing to list a number of how many homicides we've had in Cincinnati so far this year, but it's another to put 66 body bags on the sidewalk.
No more. How many more? No more.
A big and bold sign saying, "Save our youth, kings and queens, stop the violence," draped over the bridge near Martin Luther King Drive in Reading Road Saturday afternoon.
It's time to wake up the people, man. It's time to get the people to take charge and stop the senseless gun violence. I mean, we got kids doing the right thing in the house, getting ready for dinner, playing the PlayStation, and getting shot. That's ridiculous.
Mitch Morris with the Cincinnati Works Phoenix program organized a protest, saying people need to see how many lives have been lost this year alone.
We got 66 body bags out here. 56 of them have been dead by gun violence. We done had six in the last week.
Cincinnati police say 35-year-old Brandy Turner was shot to death in Over the Rhine early Saturday morning. And Greene Township police say 22-year-old Josiah Harris died Thursday after a double shooting that took place earlier this week.
The shooting, it's just gotten outrageous, and it wasn't always like that growing up in this area or in the city at all. You know, it's just gotten worse and worse over the years. And I really think that one of the main problems could be conflict resolution. People aren't using, you know, the right skills to solve their problems.
Morris says he's hoping the community will wake up and take more steps to get people to put the guns down.
Get involved, talk to your kids, talk to your family members, talk to your neighbors. Talk to them kids, see what's going on. They're making too many bad choices. It's costing them too much time in the penitentiary.
The organizers say this is important to them because they grew up in gun-infested areas, which is now the norm, and they want to change that. At CPD, Joanna Boris, Fox 19 Now.